Hello everyone, welcome to the statistic tutorial. In this video, we discuss about correlation of numeric attribute. Why we need to find the correlation? While creating a model, we find the correlation either between the independent variables or between an independent variable and the dependent variable. The correlation between the independent variable is used to remove the redundant variable, and the correlation between the independent and dependent variable is used in the selection of features for the model. Correlation of numeric attributes can be calculated using covariance and correlation coefficient. If you understand what is the formula for covariance, then it is easy to understand the correlation coefficient. So let's get started with the formula to find covariance. Covariance of numeric attributes. It is given by the equation summation of I equal to 1 to n ai minus a bar bi minus b bar by n. N is the number of records, A bar and B bar are the respective mean of features A and B. What is mean? Mean is the average value of the feature. For example, if a feature is having 10 values, then the average of 10 values gives the mean of the feature. AI is any random value of the feature, A. Bi is any random value of the feature B. Here we are finding the correlation between the feature A and B. Covariance gives the direction of relationship between the features. For example, if the covariance of A and B is greater than 0, then A and B are positively correlated. If covariance of the feature A and B is less than 0, then A and B are negatively correlated. If it is equal to 0, then we can say they both are independent. There is no relation between A and B. Let us understand the positive covariance using scatter plots. We take this example data to draw a scatter plot. I take the feature A in x-axis and the feature B in y-axis, and I plot the values. This red line is the best fit line. A bar is the mean value of all these values, and same way B bar is the mean of this set of values. AI can be any random value in the feature A in such a way that AI is less than A bar. Same way, BI is any random value in the feature B such that BI is less than B bar. So, AI minus A bar is negative. Same way, bi minus b bar is negative. So, product of both will give positive covariance. Similarly, if we take ai and bi in such a way that the value is greater than the mean a bar and b bar. In this case, ai minus a bar is positive and bi minus b bar is positive. So, product of both will give you positive covariance. So, if we examine the data, we can see the value of B increases with increase in A. Therefore, we can say A and B are positively correlated. Let's see the negative covariance using scatter plots. In this example, we can clearly understand B decreases with increase in A. Here, we are selecting the AI and BI such a way that either one of these values, See, here AI is less than A bar and BI is greater than B bar. Here AI is greater than A bar and BI is less than B bar. So in both the cases, either one is positive, other one is negative. Here it is positive, it is negative. Therefore, the product of both will give you the negative covariance. So we can say A and B are negatively correlated.
When you see this formula, we can clearly understand that the product of AI minus A bar and BI minus B bar will decide whether the covariance is positive or negative.
Hope you understand the formula for covariance. In our next video, we discuss about Pearson correlation coefficient. Thanks for watching.